This is a technical term actually. And there is an etymological derivation for that. Prati, and then there is a pratyay, those who know little Sanskrit, even you don't know, it doesn't matter, which pratitya, it makes it pratitya, and which posits that it has become into motion. Prati means something which is in front of you. Prati yogi, we have Hindi term. So, prati, here, and then sum means something together, and then utpad, the production. So, something in front of you, which is set into motion, and then sum, togetherness, and then something production. So, reality is coming into existence, something is in front of you, and it is set into motion, and the subjective reality, and then something is produced. And this is the position of Madhyamik school. So it becomes kind of interdependent production, and which is set into constant motion. So this is etymological derivation from the Sanskrit bringing here. So it becomes interdependent production. And which is generally translated as a dependent origination in English. But this is not a very good translation, dependent origination, because origination always have a connotations of something coming from, it having some origin. But anyway, this has become a popular notion. And this is the, I'm taking these idea from the text called Prasannapada, lucid words, written by Acharya Chandrakirti in 6th century, he was a Nalanda scholar. So he gives this derivation and this definition of Pratitya Samudpad in his text. And the text is a commentary on R. Nagarjuna's text called Moolya Madhyamik Karika. And this is benedictory verse. Benedictory verse means in ancient times they used to write a text and they put a Mangalacharan. And they pay homage to Buddha. So actually it's a prayer, but it's not a prayer in that sense. If you read, it says, independent origination or interdependent origination, there is no ceasing, no arising, no annihilation, no absolutism, no distinction, no sameness, no advent, and no departure. Now, I know it is not making much sense, but if you do little more focus on these terms, actually he is refuting all six modes of production. So anything comes into existence because something is ceasing, or coming into existence because something arising, or something is annihilated, or something is absolute or distinct or sameness. So he is saying if something is interdependently produced, so there is no ceasing or arising or no production from its own side. And then he says that deshayamasa sambuddhastam vande vadatam varam. He says prapancho upashamsivam, all the conceptual elaborations. When one comprehends reality with this notion, all the conceptual elaboration ceases and it's all pacified. Prapancho upasham, prapancha ka upasham ho jata, and that is so auspicious, shivam. And I prostrate to the consummate Buddha, the supreme among all teachers, one who gave this teaching. So this is kind of benedictory verse or prayer which is he is making and talking about the reality. Now why, what is the importance of this ceasing of reality? He posits that karma klesha kshayan moksha, the karma and klesha, all the afflictions, uska kshay hota hai, when that ceases, that is the moksha, the emancipation. And karma klesh, they come from vikalpa, all the thought construct, they are bringing all the afflictions, mental or physical. And te prapanchat prapanchasu, and they all has been derived from conceptual elaborations. And they cease once one is having the wisdom of emptiness. This wisdom of emptiness, he is positing that it's not different from what I just talked about, Pratitya Samudpad. So something, whatever is